We don't want to sit and keep doing this all semester. We want to try something else. So push, work together. CAD 2, CAD 3, portfolios next Friday. Highly proficient grade, highly proficient work. Are there any questions?
This is Grads Talkin' Shop. My name is G. Bundy, and I'm a teacher. That's me, and that's the Future Bus. We talk to former Beaverton students, and we learn about their career paths. Since they've left high school, they've been on their own journey, and they're all a little different. We listen to their stories so we can learn from their experiences. Today, we are heading out to MetaFab in Hillsboro to meet with Westview alum Tony Varela.
My name's Tony Varela. I graduated from Westview High School. I work at MetaFab with precision sheet metal manufacturing.
So for someone who might not have a background in metal fabrication, what could a day look like for you?
So what I do in sales and marketing role is I actually get out there and I meet with a wide, diverse set of customers, and whatever products they're looking to fabricate, we can help them find that solution. And that means any parts that end up on commercial airliners, you know, sports cars, even consumer electronics. Without anybody knowing it, you've probably come into contact with parts that we fabricated right here.
What did you do after high school? What did you think you were going to do?
Looking back at both middle school and high school, there was a couple courses that really stood out as things that I was really excited about. And that was generally shop. So in middle school, it was a shop class at Five Oaks. And then at Westview, we had an intro to CAD, computer-aided drafting, with Coach K, where we designed a cabin, and then we built a scale model of that. From his class, what really resonated for me was going from the CAD model we drew to building the scale model. Actually building something that was once in a 2D computer screen, I think that's where lights kind of went off and said, okay, that's where it really clicked. This is something that people do.
That's Coach K. He teaches manufacturing and design at Westview.
CAD 1, these dimensions, okay, they're not wrong, but if you have a lot of dimensions to put on here, it would often get awful confusing. I would say, drag this dimension all the way through and put it on the outside. Here at Westview, our kids are able to do a ton of different industry skills. And we don't say go master it. We say expose yourself to it, immerse yourself, and when you leave our school, pursue your interests.
I ended up traveling for a year, and then after that decided college was the next step. And because of that shop class with Coach K and building and designing a cabin, I really took to architecture. So I actually went off and got my degree from the University of Oregon in architecture design. I went down the architecture road, and then I went out and did some consulting on my own. After that, decided I would come back and work for the family business in sheet metal manufacturing.
Do you have to have a degree to start working here?
No, you don't. I think that's probably one of the things I want to really touch on, you know, the most, is that you don't even need the degree to become an architect like I thought I did when I graduated.
Interesting.
It's a great thing to have, and it definitely affords you a certain fast track in some regards, but it wasn't until I started working with my first architecture firm that I found that there were others that decided to go directly into the workforce. And they started with being a draftsman, and they got sponsorship from the company, and after they put together a certain amount of years of earning an income, but also gaining valuable job experience, they were at the same place I was with my advanced degree, and we could have both become architects. So roughly the same time frame. So
right.
One had 5 years of earning potential, and the other one incurred a lot of school debt.
Let's go there.
Yeah,
let's
absolutely.
Talk about school debt. I think this is a conversation that we're really wanting to have more and more, and with more transparency.
Shout it all.
I'm coming up on 20 years removed from high school, and I still have 2-3 years left of paying off those student loans. Again, a lot of good skills that I learned from college, I take with me into manufacturing. But again, that's quite a big debt load to carry for 20 years. And I don't think a lot of people realize that, you know, there's a lot of other avenues to take outside of high school than going directly into college. Maybe get out into the workforce and find something that you like to do. And then you can realize what certifications or what degrees are required for that. And then you can actually get sponsorship through your employer, or you can utilize other programs that are available to you and just end up with a less of a debt load, but then also earning potential along the way. One thing I've been thinking about a lot lately is I now have kids. I'm starting to have conversations about their college and how much we have to save for. And our financial advisor told us to plan for $250,000. And I told him absolutely not. I don't know how you ever make that money back. Something's gonna have to correct. It's either gonna be the trades or it's gonna be other options.
So in going through the shop, we saw all sorts of different processes, technologies, a lot of different roles. How does it work when someone wants to come and work for Medifab?
A lot of the positions we have, we consider them entry level. And really what that means is that you're gonna get majority of your training on the job. That's one thing we talk about a lot in these meetings with school districts. They always are asking, what can we teach our students today that will help get them ready for a life in manufacturing? Well, what kind of mathematics skills can we give them? What kind of physics or science? And really the answer we keep coming back with is just the soft skills. Some folks were even just working on handshakes and just being confident in, you know, who you are and where you're at, and understanding that what you're bringing to the table is, you know, is just that. It's yours, your own story, and just be, you know, showing up and present and eager to learn.
No matter what high school you go to, there is a CTE program available to you. Find one that interests you by talking to your counselor or by visiting our website.